The monster was too weak to do anything else than follow. The king of Dispensers, King Corland, was 80,000 strong army under the command of Marshal Kutuzov. The French army, 10,000 strong, had left Moscow in October the 19th. The first fight was at Manoyama Sides. The 24th of October, near 120 kilometers of Moscow. The way is blocked by Kutuzov. Napoleon means obtain the victory, but it is obliged to speed too much time, to spend too much time. So he decides to take the Arrivon way again, which is free. Napoleon had understood the Russian operation play then at Marlowe-Yarstadt. Then began a race between Napoleon, Kutuzov, Wittgenstein, and Chichagov. Napoleon had decided to gain time and go faster than upon the conclusion of the Russian pincer movement. As to say, to go out of the pincers below their shedding. In the case of such a race, the forces are very considered for the both sides, early because of coldness and tiredness, without considering about the struggle. The 10th of November in Smolensk, Napoleon understood that the defense of the line of the Dnieper was impossible without any hope. It was preferable to pursue the retreat still as fast as possible and to tempt the re-establishment of the defensive line along the Dnieper with the Dnieper as being as axis. In this opportunity, Napoleon called the army corps of Udino and this of Victor from the north together in Borisov, where exists a bridge across the Berezina, large of 200 meters. The Berezina River is a tributary of the Dnieper, as it is well known. A light Polish brigade under the command of Konikovsky took up the bridge of Borisov. Napoleon, the 25th of November, has reached Borisov. But the situation has completely changed. Napoleon is wrong. The bridge is destroyed, and the western side of the river is strongly occupied by the Chichagov's troops. What happened? The 18th of November, Chichagov had occupied the Minsk and gone to the Berezina River. He occupied the western side and Borisov. Konikovsky left Borisov the 20th of November to join Udino on the eastern side, of the Berezina. Konikovsky preferred to save his brigade and defend the most strong of the wages. He was chased away by Chichagov, who knocks against the core of Udino, and is beaten off and pushed to the Berezina, the 23rd. Then he retreated to the Berezina to Borisov. rocks, gates, bars of and a bridge. But can't maintain the conquest. The Russian occupy again Borisov and burn the bridge. However, Chichatov has to desert the material of his core and a part of it, his bridge building material. This will be very interesting for the French army, which has destroyed a part of bridge building material at Orshan, on the east of Smolensk. That is the situation founded by Napoleon the 25th of November at night when he breached Borisov. The French army is into the pincers, surrounded by three enemy armies, and the way to France is blocked by the Berezina with thumping. About Berezina, above Borisov, about 12 kilometers, exists a fort. Near the village of Studenka, and then the possibility of to build a bridge. But the Russians know the existence of this fort and offer Studenka. On the east, Kutuzov began to deploy his corps, his troops, his guard, from the column order to the battle formation. The whole French army included still 90,000 men, but only 50,000 combatants are organized in fighting units. The other are stragglers, bands, starving and frozen, oft without weapons, unable to fight. Napoleon, during the night of 25th of November, gave the order to burn the flights of the destroyed and dissolved regiments. Any field marshals rate to negotiate a capitulation. The answer of Napoleon was clear. Never. No surrender. Better to die. He searched for a new operation plan. He found it. A light cavalry brigade had crossed the Berezina student camp and reports that it's possible to stay to lay the bridge. Napoleon thinks, a century ago, the king of Sweden, Charles XII, had crossed the Berezina marching to Poltava, making use of two forts. The first one, well known at Studenka, the second one, downstream of Borisov, about 30 kilometers near the village of Puchlodi. Puchlodi or Puchlodi. Napoleon decides a diversion, and the 25th of November, he sends two army corps, Udino and Victor, to Puchlodi. At the same time, he ordered a light detachment with some engineers. The remainders of two engineers' regiments, and what is necessary for a bridge building to move to Studenka under the command of General Avery. These two regiments are from a Dutch recruitment and turned out a 400-strong detachment. The Pontoniers detachment is protected by a brigade who has beforehand tigers for organized troops. Chichagov is convinced that Napoleon's plan is to take the fort of Buchlovi by storm and then cross the river at that place. Because of that, all Russian forces are concentrated on the south of Borisov and withdraw Studenka. The movement far on the south of the weak detachment of Dombrovsky strengthens Chichagov in his opinion. During the one night and the day after, the 26th of November, two bridges are built on the Berezina. The first for infantry, the second for artillery. The pontooners have walked into frozen water, wandered by lumps of floating ice. To drive Trestle on to the water, many pontooners had frozen water right up to one's neck. Few pontooners were out alive, perhaps about 20, not more. The general Ebley himself was exhausted until death at Königsberg in December 1812. As soon as this was possible, in the morning of the 27th, the war ground and many army corps, sometimes reduced to the third of the insurgent strength, crossed the river. The second army corps, Udino, moving to position on the western side of the river, faced the future attack of Chichagov, who, recognizing his error, should come back. So was it. The 27th of November, the same day, Chichagov was counter-attacked on the front and the flank. Driven to the river, sustained strong casualties, dead and wounded, their prisoners, obliged to retreat. All these attempts are doomed to fail. Another French army corps is charged with Wittgenstein in purpose to reduce or to stop the speed of his offensive. The rest of the army get ready for crossing the river and dig. The rear guard contains the attack of Kutuzov, who spent time to adapt many battle formation from the marching columns. All day long, it was a bitter struggle. The Russians met difficulties in their maneuver because they don't have good binding between the four. Lots of French traveler understanding that was given the battle for the survival and the return home of the army joined the organized and stronger units. The Frenchmen maintained their position. The struggle continued from the night. The 29th of November, early in the morning, the battle starts again. The bridge is broken. The retreat is very slow. The broken bridge is repaired and broken and repaired anew again. At the end of the day, Kutuzov managed to concentrate all his troops. He decided a general attack for the next day. In the night, the last organized corps preaches. First version Wittgenstein hat uns gebracht. Deutschland hat mistakes on the eastern side of the Berezina with 40,000 prisoners. Strugglers and one, only one organized unit. What remained of the division of General Bartholomew, which got lost into the gore of Wittgenstein during the snowstorm. The Russian pursuit continued, but slowly, because the force was the cause of sufferers of casualties. The Frenchmen are unable to mind and care about the prisoners of Chichak and Salamanca. So they are discharged in exchange for people's promise. Not fight against human again. The 5th of December at Smolny, Napoleon left the command of the army to go as fast as possible to Paris, where he was on hikings at night. The defensive line of the Niemen then held no more than the Vistula. After the order, the French army stopped his retreat on the line of Elbe, by the river, and the Wilbur organized. The Russian army was unable to start an attack, although the greater part of French units are reduced to very few numbers of more men. No one unit was dissolved. They will find their normal strength as and when will come reinforcement for France, Italy, Germany, Poland, and so on. The will win to win of Napoleon was sufficient for making efforts. Napoleon don't wait for the attack of the coalition. The 1st of May, 1813, the French army, 300,000 strong, is going to counterattack the surprised coalition. The most part of soldiers, of French soldiers, was very young, 17 or 18 years old, but with the officer of the Heart Corps saved from Russia. As it's good known, at least, it was the French defeat. The coalition was too late. Remain among friends. The glory and the lesson never surrender. A century and a half after, the Gore and the Frenchmen didn't forget the lesson and continue on the war with the Allies until the victory. Thank you.